Am I audible, Ajay? Ajay?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay. Just wait, huh? Some of the candidates, they are intrigued. Just wait. So now let's start. I will share the screen. Just a minute, Manish Kumar. Share screen. So after the completion of spontaneous and stimulated emission, we will go into the population inversion. Main thing of this topic is population inversion. So in population inversion, we know that if the lower energy level, if the lower energy level is more populated, then the lower upper energy level, means you can see that here an atom is in the lower energy level, and in upper energy level there is no atom are kept in the are not placed in this upper energy level. It means an atom, a single atom is placed this energy level is more populated than the upper energy level. So in this case, absorption process will take place. But here in this figure, an atom is placed in the upper energy level and there is no atom lying in this lower energy level. So this figure indicates the spontaneous emission or stimulated emission. Means here in this figure, higher population is available in the upper energy level. So if the upper energy level is more populated than the lower energy level, then stimulated emission will take place. For laser action, this word is very much important. For laser action, higher population is required in the upper energy level. Higher population is required in the upper energy level. So for laser action, it is must. Now if we have taken in a container some of the atoms are available, suppose here we have taken a enclosure and atoms are present in this enclosure, and this enclosure and the enclosure is heated with a temperature T. So in that case, we can see that all the atoms are moving all directions. Means some of the atoms moves from lower to upper direction, or few of the atoms moving from upper to lower direction like this. So in that case, there are, according to this diagram, when control and enclosures are heated with the temperature T, the atoms are moving in all directions. Means these three processes is to be created. Means if the atoms move from lower part of the container to upper part of the container, then in that case, adsorption process will be held. And if the atoms are coming from upper part of this container to lower part of the container, then spontaneous or stimulated emission will be created. So for population inversion, if when in thermal equilibrium at a temperature T, in thermal equilibrium at a temperature T, the number of atoms distributed among various energy levels. Here, look my cursor. So according to Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution function, if suppose there are so many energy levels, E1, E2, E3, E4 like this, EI, maximum energy level is suppose EI, here I, E sufficient I. So suppose if EI be the maximum energy levels. So in the energy level E1, the number of atoms present in this energy level is N1. For N2 energy level, the number of atoms is N2. Like this, for N3 energy level, E3 energy level, N3 number of atoms are present. So in EI number, upper energy level, uppermost energy level is suppose EI. So EI energy level have, suppose NI number of NI here, I have written N suffix high, I. NI number of atoms in the upper energy level, uppermost energy level. So number of atoms NI, according to Boltzmann distribution function, we can write that this NI is equal to N naught be the number of atoms present in the ground state energy level or lower state energy level, E epsilon minus EI be the energy equal to H mu. So here energy level EI divided by K beta T. K beta is the Boltzmann constant and T is the absolute temperature. Here I have applied a temperature for heating this container. So according to Boltzmann distribution function, we can write Ni is equal to N naught, this is not N0, N naught, Ni number of atoms in the EI energy level, N naught with the number of atoms present in the ground state energy level, this E epsilon EI divided by K beta T, EI with the energy levels E1 minus E2 like this, or E2 to minus E3. Divided by K beta is the Boltzmann constant and T with the absolute temperature. These are already, this notes is already given in earlier classes. So you have to see that what is the full form of Ni NO. So here we have told about only two energy levels. So two energy levels, E1 with the energy level and E2 with the energy level. So in this, according to these energy levels, if N1 number of atoms is present in the energy level E1 and N2 be the number of atoms present in this energy level E2. So in this case, we can write here Ni. In place of Ni, we can write N2. N2 number of atoms, N2 is equal to N0 in place of N0. N0 means a number of atoms present in the ground state energy level. So here, according to this figure, we can say that N1 be the number of atoms present in this energy level E1. So here we can write N1 in place of N0. We can write N1 E epsilon EI means the difference between the two energy levels, that is E1 minus E2 divided by this K beta T. Now here N2 divided by N1 is equal to E epsilon EI, E1 minus E2 divided by K beta T. This E1 minus E2 is equal to E, energy level E. We know that E is equal to H mu. So in place of E, because of E, we can write H mu. H is the Planck constant, mu is the frequency of radiation. So N2 divided by N1 is equal to E epsilon H mu divided by K beta T. This is the population inversion, derivation part of the population inversion is given here. So the resultant we have got N2 by N1 is equal to E epsilon H mu divided by K beta T. Now, next is Einstein's A and B coefficient. In university exam, university will ask, describe the phenomena of population inversion and derive an expression for Einstein's coefficients or Einstein's A and B coefficients. So, in this case, these two figures, which these are the two figures which is used for the Einstein's A and B coefficient. If atoms are placed in this enclosures or container, and this container is heated with a temperature T, then all these three processes, absorption, spontaneous, and stimulated emission will take place. Means when we apply a temperature in the container, means in the thermal equilibrium condition, the rate of upward transition, look my cursor, upward transition means when the atoms moves from lower direction to upper direction, E1 to E2, the rate of upward transition must be equal to the rate of downward transition, means atom moves from E2 energy level to E1 energy level. Now, all these three processes will be adapted, taken at a time T. Suppose T, it takes time T. Now, if previously for population inversion, we have told that N1 be the number of atoms, N1 be the number of atoms present in the E1 energy level. Here I have written E1. And in this E1 energy level, N1 number of atoms are available. And for E2 be the upper energy level, and in this energy level, N2 be the number of atoms are present. So if there are N1 number of atoms per unit volume, N1 number of atoms per unit volume, look my cursor, with energy E1 in the ensemble here, in this ensemble, then in that case, absorption transition rate from E1 to E2 is N1 energy density U mu and B12. N1 be the number of atoms in the lower energy level, E1, because absorption process will be held if the atoms go from downward lower energy state to upper energy state. So in lower energy state, there are N1 number of atoms are available. So in this case, if the absorption process will be held in the presence of N1 number of atoms, and it takes time T when it moves from lower to upper direction, that absorption process will take place, transition rate from E1 to E2 can be written as dN1 divided by dT. Absorption is equal to B12 U mu N1. B12 is constant. Here I have written B12. B12 means the atoms in initial condition, atoms are present in the lower energy level 1. After some time, it reaches to the upper energy level 2. So first, 1 can be written because a number of atoms are available in the initial state. It is present in energy level E1. And 2, after that, 2 will has to be written because the atoms coming to the energy level 2. Here, U mu is the energy density. N1 be the number of atoms present in the lower energy level. Equation one indicates the rate of transition, absorption transition rate, equation 1 indicates the absorption transition rate like this. Similarly, if there are N2 atoms per unit volume with energy level E2 in this ensemble, then stimulated emission rate from E2 to E1, E2 to E1, here I have written E2 to E1, stimulated STI can be written as N2 U mu B20. So here, rate of downward transition, stimulated transition rate is dN2 divided by dt. Stimulated is equal to B21 U mu N22. B21, I have written because at initial stage, the atoms are available present in the upper energy level 2. After some time, it goes towards the lower energy level 1. So first, the atoms is available on the level 2. So we can write first 2. After that, when the atom reaches to lower energy level, means 1, so it can be written as B21. And U mu, this is the energy density. This part is said to be energy density. And N2 to be the number of atoms present in the upper energy level. So stimulated transition rate for stimulated emission is equal to equation 2. Now, next process will be held, that is spontaneous emission. So the spontaneous transition rate from energy level E2 to E1 is N21. And in this case, it is independent of the energy density. So here I have not written energy density, because transition rate from E2 to E1 is N22. And this is, and it is independent of the energy density. So here we have not write energy density. Means the transition rate of spontaneous transition,
sir,
is,
sir,
yes, yes.
Sir, spontaneous emission energy density pe kaha depend nahi karega?
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Ha, this term will arise coming through Planck constant. After discussion in this topic, we have used a term Planck constant formula for energy density.
Or sir, spontaneous mein aur stimulated mein dono mein sir E2 से E1 आ रहा है, दोनों में डिफरेंस क्या है सर?
स्टिमुलेटेड और स्पॉन्टेनियस? हां, लुक दिस डायग्राम, है ना? इन दिस डायग्राम हियर
दोनों में E2 से E1 आ रहा है सर.
हियर इन द फॉर स्पॉन्टेनियस इमिशन देयर आर ए सिंगल फोटोन इमिटेड ड्यूरिंग दिस प्रोसेस, सिंगल फोटोन. ओके, नाउ फॉर दिस प्रोसेस, emission process is stimulated, there are two or more than photons are emitted during this process, stimulated emission. These are the basic difference between the spontaneous and stimulated emission. Okay, Asutosh?
Haan, sir.
For spontaneous emission, there is a single photon emitted when an atom jumps from upper energy to lower energy level. It takes time 10 to the power minus 8 seconds, and it emits a single photon of energy H mu. And for stimulated emission, if an atom jumps from upper energy to lower level energy level, it takes time 10 to the power minus 8 seconds, and during this period, two or more than two photons are emitted. After reaching to this lower energy level, the atom should not be in the stable position. Pehle sun to lo baat. Hello? Hello?
Haan sir, boliye.
तुम जो पाठ बोल रहे हो तुमको तीन चार बार से हम पहले से बता रहे हैं कि स्पॉन्टेनियस इमिशन देयर इज अ सिंगल फोटोन इमिटेड ड्यूरिंग दिस प्रोसेस. दिस इज द रिपीटेड क्लास. फर्स्ट यू हैव टू लर्न द नोट्स यू हैव अवेलेबल. आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन नोट्स. दिस इज द सेकेंड टाइम आई हैव टीच spontaneous emission. First question, what is absorption? Absorption process is given here. After the completion of absorption process, the atom reaches to the upper energy level E2. Okay, Ashutosh?
No, sir.
After reaching to the upper energy level E2, this atom wants to go to the downward direction. So in that case, the atoms tries to come to the lower direction. So it jumps from upper energy level to lower energy level. It takes time 10 to the power minus 8 seconds and it emits a photon of energy h mu. This is the spontaneous emission. Now stimulated emission, after reaching to the ground state, the atom said atom is to be stable. Now we are talking about stimulated emission. When the atom jumps from upper energy level, sometimes it may be occur that when atom jumps from upper energy level to lower energy level, two or more than two photons are emitted. Look this diagram. And after reaching to the ground lower energy level or ground state, the atom cannot be in the stable mode. Okay, this is the basic difference between spontaneous and stimulated emission. Ashutosh?
Yes, sir.
Anybody want to ask me? Hello? Now, next. So equation 1, 2, and 3. Equation 1 is the absorption transition rate when the atoms move from energy level 1 to energy level 2. Equation 2 is the transition rate, stimulated transition rate when the atom jumps from upper energy level to lower energy level, 2 to 1 energy level. Now 3 is coming from spontaneous emission. Means here there are only a single photon is emitted for equation 3. So equation here, look, absorption process is from downward to upper direction, and spontaneous and stimulated emission in the upward to downward direction. So this absorption transition rate must be equal to sum of the spontaneous emission, spontaneous transition rate or emission of stimulated transition rate. This, the value of transition rate of absorption is given in equation 1. So absorption process here, we can write absorption transition rate is equal to spontaneous transition rate plus stimulated transition rate. So the value of absorption transition rate, that is B12 energy density N1, is equal to stimulated emission. The value of stimulated transition rate is equal to B21 energy density U mu N2 plus the transition rate of spontaneous emission is N2 A21. We can write all these terms which are used in all these three equations. So after solving this equation, we can write B12 energy density N1, here this is N1, minus B12 energy density N2 coming towards the left direction. Means here positive sign is given here, so it is converted to minus sign. B21 energy density N2 plus is equal to rest part is N2A21. So in this case, here energy density is given in both the steps. So here we can take energy density taken as a common. So rest part is B12 N1 minus B21 N2. First we have taken energy density taken as a common. So rest part is B12 N1 minus B21 N2 is equal to here N2 A21. So we have calculated the energy density is equal to N2 divided by N2 into A21 divided by here B12 N1 minus B21 N2, equation 4. After coming into the equation 4, we know that for laser action, higher population is required in the upper energy level. So in this case, higher number of population is in the upper energy level E2, that is N2. N2 with the higher number of population in the upper energy level, E2. So this N2 means the maximum number of atoms, N2, is divided in equation 4 of all terms. So energy density is equal to N2 divided by N2, A21 divided by upon N1 upon N2, here N2, I have written N2, B12, minus, again, here N2 is given here, this part, N2 upon N2 into B20. So N2 and T will be cancelled. Why we can use N2? Somebody asked you, why you have to use N2 in energy density? So you will give your answer. If lower energy level is more populated than upper, so in this case, absorption process will be take place. And if the upper energy level is more populated than lower, so stimulated emission will take place. For laser action, higher population is required in the upper energy level. Higher population is required in the upper energy level for laser action. The whole process is known as population inversion. Here, according to this diagram, we can say that N2 be the number of atoms, maximum number of atoms present in the upper energy level in comparison to lower energy level. Lower energy level has few number of atoms are available, but in upper energy level, more number of atoms are available. That is, N2 number of atoms are available. That's why we have written here N2, and this N2 divided by N2, A21 upon here N1, this part is coming from transition rate for absorption, N1 upon N2, N1 by N2, and this B12 minus here N2 by N2 B20. So this part will cancel. Rest part is energy density is equal to A21 divided by N1 by N2 B12 minus B20. This is equation 5. Energy density, equation 5 indicates the energy density equation. Energy density is equal to A21. A21 is a constant when the atoms jumps from energy level 2 to energy level 1 divided by N1 by N2. N1 be the number of atoms present in the lower energy level U1, N2 be the atoms present in the upper energy level. Here B12 is again constant minus B21 is another constant. B12 is constant when the atoms and it is coming from this absorption process. Means atoms jump from lower energy level to upper energy level. Energy level 1 to energy level 2 minus. Here B21 is the constant because the atoms jump from energy level 2 to energy level 1. So equation 5 is for energy density. Now, according to Boltzmann distribution function, we know that according to Boltzmann distribution function, here N2 divided by N1 is equal to this part. This part. If we can write in place of N2, N1 divided by N2, in place of N2, we can write N2. In place of N1, we can write N2. So N1 divided by N2. So here, E plus H mu divided by K beta T. If we interchange N1 and N2, then in this case, here minus H mu can be changed into plus H mu divided by K beta T. According to Boltzmann distribution function, by this figure, we can write N1 by N2 is equal to this part. N1 be the number of atoms in the lower energy level, and N2 be the upper number of atoms in the upper energy level. So, this equation 5 can be written. Means when we put the value of N1 by N2 in this equation 5, so we can write that energy density is equal to A21 divided by, here in place of N1 by N2, here N1 by N2 is given here into B12. So B12 is written here into N1 by N2. N1 by N2 means the value of N1 by N2 is E H mu divided by K beta T. H is Planck constant. Mu is the frequency of radiation divided by Boltzmann constant. K beta. Beta A. This is not B. It is known as Boltzmann constant. T is the absolute temperature. So this part is written here. Minus B21. Here equation. This equation is suppose equation 6. Now, according to the Planck's formula for energy density, it depends upon velocity of light. Energy density is equal to 8 pi h mu cube divided by c cube. C cube is the velocity of light into 1 by e h mu divided by k beta t. Suppose this is equation 5. According to after the completion of equation 6, we can write a statement. According to equation 6 is coming by the statement of Boltzmann distribution function. Equation 6 has to become. Now, after this equation, we can write here. According to the Planck's formula for energy density, only for energy density, equation 6 this is coming this equation is also indicates the energy density due to Boltzmann distribution function, but Planck's formula states only about the energy density. So Planck's formula state according to the Planck's formula for energy density, we can write at u mu is equal to this part 8 pi h mu cube divided by c cube into 1 by e h mu divided by k beta t. So here suppose this is equation 7. Now in equation 6 and 7, in both the equation, in left hand side energy density are given here. In both the equation energy density are given in the left direction. So in that case, we can equating equation 6 and 7. Here I am missing writing equation 7. Suppose equating both these equation 6 and 7. Equation 6 is to be due to the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution function. Here equation 5, equation 6. So last equation 6 is coming due to Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution function. And equation 7 here, equation 7 is due to Planck's formula for energy density. Planck's formula indicates states that energy density is equal to 8 pi, and it is related to the velocity of light. So energy density for Planck's formula is equal to this part. After equating equation 6 or 7, we can write A21 divided by B12 EH mu divided by K beta T minus B21 is equal to equating equation 6 or 7. This part is equal to this part. Means A21 means A part is equal to 8 pi H mu to C cube into 1 by E H mu divided by K beta T. So in this case, in both the sides, here E H mu divided by K beta T is given here. So rest part is A21 B12 equal to A21 B21. Rest part here B21 is equal to this 8 pi H mu cube divided by C cube. After equating equation 6 and 7, rest part, this part is written in the left direction, or this part is written in right direction. So in both the directions, E H mu divided by K beta T is available. So this part is cancelled, will be cancelled. So next part is A21 divided by B12 is equal to A21 divided by B21 is equal to, here rest part is 8 pi h mu cube divided by c cube. Energy density, for energy density this part we have written. So after cancellation of this part, rest part is 8 pi h mu cube c cube. So A21 divided by B12 is equal to A21 divided by B21. A21 and A21 will be cancelled. So rest part is B12 is equal to B21 is equal to 8 pi h mu q c q. This last statement of this Einstein's A and B coefficient indicates that when B12 is taken as a constant and B21 is also constant, B12 means when the atoms, number of atoms goes from lower upper energy.